Family, parents, wrong speech. Good morning, Sister C. Mann, Mr. Jeffries, Mrs. K. here, Ms. Farrell, faculty, staff, fellow students, and guests. Wow, what an honor it is to be standing up here in front of you today. I would first like to thank you, my fellow students, for giving me the opportunity to lead you as your president for the upcoming school year. I am so grateful to be accepting the gavel from our past president, Nick Giangiulio. Many of you remember Nick from last year. If I had to sum up Nick in one phrase, it would be setting the bar high. Not just for me as president, or everyone behind me as a member of the leadership council, but for everyone in front of me, as people, as students, as brothers. I was on the football and lacrosse teams with Nick last year. I remember him always being that positive force on both our teams, always being the first one to congratulate someone on a great play or telling someone that they'll get it next time when they made a mistake. While we were losing, Nick was the guy to never doubt our teams, telling us that we could come back if we worked as a team. To me, Nick was the perfect example of what it meant to be a brother. We should always be striving to reach this high bar that Nick has set for us. Nick's impact didn't just last when he was at St. Mel's. His example imprinted on all of us so we could follow it and pass it on long after he graduated. In my election speech, I talked about how you must first look in the mirror to make the change in yourself to influence others. For example, last year at recess, I would rush over to the basketball courts every day, hardly waiting to play a game. This year, I'm going to make that change myself and look around the recess yard to make sure no one is sitting by themselves or is being excluded from the game. It is these small changes that make us better brothers. We must all make this change this year, right now, so that our example is remembered and is carried on through the legacy of our brothers. I would also like to congratulate everyone behind me who was elected as a member of the Leadership Council. Luke, Jake, Aiden, Z, and all the homeroom reps. I'm looking forward to a great year with you by carrying on the example of past councils as well as setting the bar even higher for future ones. But I must remind everyone here today, whether you ran for a position on the council or not, that you do not need to wear a pin on your blazer to set this example of being a brother. You do not need a pin to be a leader and influence other students to do the same. You do not need a pin to carry on the St. Aloysius legacy through the IHM virtues of love, creative hope, and fidelity. Let us all strive to set this positive example so that we may carry on the legacy at St. Aloysius and set the bar even higher for future years to come. I would like to help create an atmosphere of true brotherhood here that makes everyone want to go to school every morning, knowing that they always have a friend, a brother, at 401 South Primore Avenue. But I can't do it without your help. Come June, I want us to be able to look back and say that it was the best year at St. Al's we've ever had. Thank you.